Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic is an absolute classic, and for many, myself included, the game that opened the door from the movies to the wider expanded universe of Star Wars. With the remake just announced 2 weeks ago, there is a lot we still don't know, but that doesn't mean we know nothing. So today I'm here to talk to you about three big things that we know for certain about the KOTOR remake, and three pressing questions that need to be answered soon. Today's video is brought to you by Manscaped. Did you know that 85% of women prefer a mowed lawn? It's true. Look at this patch right here. I was supposed to take care of this weeks ago, but it's such a pain to get out all the equipment for just this. Plus, it's really scary when dealing with such a tight area because one wrong turn and the blades will catch the ground and send dirt and rocks pelting everywhere. That is why Darth Wife is so thankful for the precise and specialized Lawnmower 4.0 that Manscaped sent me. With the Lawnmower 4.0, I can get around these tight corners without nicking the ground or mowing areas that I don't want mowed. It is perfectly suited for gliding around these precise curves and corners, making it the ideal tool for precision landscaping. Click the link in the description and use the promo code LORE20 to get 20% off your very own Perfect Package 4.0 so that you can have the safest and most precise way to improve your presentability. Wait, I'm supposed to use it on what? The Lawnmower by Manscaped. The grass is greener when it's shorter. Before we get into this, I actually recently did a review of Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic on my Gimme page, and you can check that out by the link in the description. But I also recently did a review of my favorite BioWare game, Mass Effect, and that link is also in the description. If you click that link in the description, you will get to see my thoughts and opinions on my favorite BioWare game of all time, actually my favorite video game of all time, and my second favorite science fiction property coming in just under Star Wars. Gimme is a great platform that allows you guys to ask me direct questions about the things I'm reviewing and see how I really feel about them and get to see my scores and rankings, and I'll pick three characters and three maps from every game to do a little bit more of a detailed breakdown on, and it's just a really great place to see me talk about stuff other than here on YouTube. So feel free to check that out. Links are in the description below. The first thing that I think everyone needs to know is that the game will be available at launch on the PC as well as the PS5. When the game was first announced, there was a massive confusion, to which I contributed, that the Knights of the Old Republic remake would only be available as a PlayStation 5 exclusive. However, it was revealed that, one, it was only that the PS5 would be the console exclusive at launch. It would be available on PC and the PlayStation at launch, but it would be brought to the Xbox at some point later, possibly even having a port for the Switch. However, I do think that's possibly unlikely since they are going to just be releasing the original KOTOR on the Switch this coming November. This brings us to our first pressing question, which is, when will the game be released on the Xbox? In fact, we don't have a release date at all for the game. In an interview with the PlayStation blog, they stated that the remake is still, quote, in early stages of development, offering absolutely no information or nothing to inform a potential release date for the game, much less the delayed Xbox release. The second thing that we know for certain is that the game will be a remake. According to the interview available on PlayStation.blog, they said, quote, "We are rebuilding one of the greatest RPGs of all time for a new generation with modern tech, features, visuals, and more, while maintaining the integrity of the story and characters that we've all come to cherish." This means that this is not a new interpretation, this is not a remaster or a reskin, this is a full remake. This isn't like what they did when bringing back Grand Admiral Thrawn. This is supposed to be telling the original story with the original characters, beat for beat, at least according to what they're saying here. This is a remake of the original game. To what degree will the game be remade? Is it just a reskin? What they said was, quote, that this remake encompasses almost every aspect of the original game, meaning that they are going to be redoing the combat, they are going to revamp the graphics. This likely won't just be Halo Anniversary or the Mass Effect Legendary Edition. This is an actual ground up remake, which I find a really, really exciting prospect. They also brought in some of the original voice actors to do new lines. Okay, so the only one we really know for sure is Jennifer Hale, the voice of Bastila Shan, because we have new voice lines from Jennifer Hale in the new KOTOR trailer.
We face the greatest Sith in generations. They must be stopped.
The only teaser trailer that exists at this point is narrated by Bastila Shan with lines that we have never heard before in either of the original KOTOR games or even Star Wars The Old Republic, where Jennifer Hale once again voiced the character of Bastila Shan as well as other characters such as the female Republic trooper and Satil Shan. What this means, however, is that at least some of the voice actors are being brought back to bring in new content, which is something that excites me to endless degrees. The next thing we don't know, however, is whether or not this entry will be canon. We as the fans have been waiting for the canonization of Revan pretty much since Disney took over and decanonized the EU. It was pretty much, but we like Revan and we like Thrawn. And they brought back Thrawn a few years back with Star Wars Rebels Season 3. And now we have the first official release of something under Disney with Revan. But the question is, will it be canon? And while the obvious answer might seem to be yes, it isn't quite as cut and dry as that. See, not only is the game coming out under Disney, but not everything that has come out under Disney has been canon. Look at SWTOR Knights of the Fallen Empire as something that was made by BioWare and published by EA and released under Disney, but still isn't canon. The story of Zakuul and the Eternal Empire has never been canon. It was created after Disney took over, but was still a part of the Legends timeline. So the question is, will KOTOR be part of the Legends timeline, or will it be canon? On the other hand, we also have things like the Bad Batch unfinished episodes, where we saw those made under Lucasfilm before Disney, and then they were released under Disney with some minor tweaks, and now that storyline is brought in and fully canonized. Also, we do know that the character of Revan is a canon character in the Star Wars timeline, so it stands to reason that we should get some canon content featuring that character. Obviously, the grand hope is that this will be a canon story and that it will be bringing Revan officially into canon. Now, the next thing that we know is that the remake is being written by Sam Maggs. When searching the phrase Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic remake, the first suggested search result is Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic remake woke, which tells me that this is a topic with which many of you are concerned. And a lot of this concern comes down to the fact that the remake is being written by Sam Maggs, a person who has contributed in a controversial way to this woke topic when it comes to Star Wars. Now, I don't want to make this about whether you do or don't, or even should or shouldn't agree with Sam Maggs' stances when it comes to activism in Star Wars. Sam Maggs has a long history of tweets designed to split the Star Wars community, but the one thing that I really want to talk to you about is something that shouldn't be controversial. It's the quote where she says, "Isn't KOTOR your favorite?" To which her answer is no. As we discussed in the last 2 points, this is a remake, not a remaster. And as we already said, the first thing that we know, almost every aspect of the original game is being rebuilt. All we really know, however, is that Sam Maggs is involved with the writing of the remake. Anything beyond that goes into the territory of things we don't know. So, continuing the topic of Sam Maggs, now in the context of things we don't know, the third thing we don't know is, will they ruin KOTOR? Let's speculate for a minute on what we don't know. It's important to remember that there is a lot we don't know about the changes that will be made to KOTOR and how extreme those changes are going to be, and the subsequent benevolence of said changes. As near as I can tell, the biggest concern would really be changes made to the character of Bastila. My predecessor and Jedi Master Dash actually mentioned this in his recent video over on his channel, Game Lore Dash, and I'll have a link to that down in the description so that you can check that out as soon as you're done with this video here. I also have a review of KOTOR over on my Gimme page and a dedicated little mini video on Bastila, so feel free to check that out. There'll be a link in the description for that as well. Now, Bastila is probably my second favorite Jedi of all Star Wars. maybe third. I don't know. Dooku and Revan are both just awesome characters. But anyway, I think that Bastila really represents the failings and the redemption of the Jedi, living as a perfect embodiment of their journey throughout Lucas's six films.
Yeah, it's like poetry, sort of, they rhyme.
Bastila starts off as an arrogant and narrow-minded character. She is so stuffed to the brim with ineffectual platitudes that she never stops to think that she may be actually living out dark side practices and mentalities more than serving the light.
So you're saying we should have done nothing? Just let the Mandalorians conquer us unopposed? I mean, the Republic was under attack, and the Order abandoned us.
We did not abandon you, but the Council were not about to throw lives away foolishly.
Bastila's hubris leaves her vulnerable for the dark side to take over, and she must eventually be stripped of all facades before finally admitting that the platitudes were, in fact, wrong, and that the Jedi Code is not the key to the light side. Balance in the Force is love.
I'll not leave you here. I've got to save you.
You're ready.
See, BioWare is known for their characters. It's like their thing. All the characters are great because they are real and have real and relatable flaws. Flaws that are addressed and overcome throughout the game. See, Karth is virtuous and brave, but he doesn't trust like that.
I don't trust like that.
Kandaris is strong and loyal and fearless, but he's also calloused and ungentle. Jolly Bindo is easily the wisest Jedi to ever live, while also being almost deliberately cranky, jaded, and almost mean. Mission is crafty, smart, and caring, but she's also cocky and easily agitated. Juhani is loyal and selfless and adoring, but she's also hairless furry bait. I mean, she's also tried to kill her Jedi Master in anger. And of course, that brings us to Bastila, who is dedicated, passionate, and the most powerful Jedi alive. But there's a cognitive dissonance that prevents her from seeing the gray and forces her to walk in the dark while thinking and speaking in the light. Bastila is so well written, and her journey is one of the most important in the entire Old Republic era because Bastila is the ultimate victim of the Jedi Masters. She is forced to say that passion is wrong, while her own passion for the Order and for the light side is one of her biggest strengths. She is forced to say that romance is evil, while it is only love that draws her back into the light. It's like if you've ever met someone who was raised in a really strict and legalistic environment. They were conditioned to believe that these restrictions were good and that judging others by these restrictions is also somehow in service of the good, but it only ends up hurting everyone around them and especially themselves. So it's no wonder that people are concerned that Bastila would be rewritten to remove all of her flaws, or even worse, to be rewritten so that her character growth, that the overcoming of her flaws, is seen as unnecessary and therefore doesn't happen. Bastila's character growth is like the linchpin of KOTOR. It's what makes her one of the greatest characters ever written. But even if things look bleak, I'm not convinced that this is something about which we should be seriously worried. Bastila's growth is a central thread in KOTOR's storyline. You can't remove it without unraveling the entire story. So allow me to be fair for a moment. Mag's history of commenting on other Star Wars properties aside, the biggest concern here seems to be the tweet where she says KOTOR is not her favorite. So Sam Biggs was answering a question wherein she was asked, "Is KOTOR your favorite?" To which she responded, "No." And as far as I've searched, I can't actually find a link to that tweet, only screenshots which don't include the original question she's answering, so I don't know the context of the question, and context is really important. See, in a different tweet, Mags commented at her elation at finally being able to work on a BioWare property. If being asked if KOTOR was her favorite BioWare property, my answer would also be no. For me, that title goes to Mass Effect 2, so someone could ask me, "Is KOTOR your favorite BioWare game?" And I'd be like, "No, it's not. It's my second favorite, and by a very narrow margin, but that title goes to Mass Effect 2. That's my favorite BioWare game. In fact, there's a large portion of the KOTOR fan community that wouldn't even give KOTOR the title of their favorite Old Republic game, giving that award instead to KOTOR 2. It's very common for people to prefer KOTOR 2 over KOTOR 1. In fact, I believe that my predecessor Dash even feels that way. In short, this hiring does not speak to the inevitable doom of the KOTOR remake. Just because something isn't your favorite doesn't mean that you don't absolutely love it. Sure, KOTOR isn't my favorite BioWare game, but it is a very close second, and as I said, by a very, very narrow margin. It is my second favorite video game of all time, by a very narrow margin. As I said, Bastila's weakness and growth is a central thread in the KOTOR story. You can't take that away without a full rewrite, and they said that they are trying to preserve the original story and the original characters. I'll read the quote again. "We are rebuilding one of the greatest RPGs of all time for a new generation with modern tech, features, visuals, and more, while maintaining the integrity of the story and the characters that we've all come to cherish." Unless they are so freaking oblivious that they don't understand that growth and weakness is a central part of a character's integrity, then I really don't think there's anything about which we have to be worried. Now, even though we know that Jennifer Hale has returned to do new lines, I am holding out hope that this doesn't spell out death for the remake, but that these are just going to be new lines that either add to the lore or the characters. I'm hopeful. I think that this is going to be good. I know that there are people involved who have a track record that is controversial, but I really just want to hope for the best. I am going to play the remake as soon as it releases, and I'll have a full review for you once it does. And if you're someone that's worried about the narrative flow of KOTOR being just absolutely decimated or being so muddled and clouded by things that people want to change that shouldn't be changed, just wait for my review. I promise that I will leave no stone unturned, and if they ruin Bastila's character, you know that I am going to say something about it. I won't ask any of you to buy the game blind like me, before you even know whether the game has been ruined, preserved, or even enhanced. I just ask, please, that you reserve judgment until we know for sure. If you need to wait until other people have played the game and reviewed it, find a source that you trust and just wait for them. But anyway, guys, those were three things that we know for sure about the KOTOR remake, as well as three things that we absolutely don't know. Were there any I missed? Let me know your thoughts down in the comments below, and especially in the comments below, let me know if you are excited for the KOTOR remake or if this information is concerning enough to make you trepidatious. As I said, whether you are optimistic or pessimistic, let's not execute judgment until we know for certain, and let's just wait for the facts. Let's wait for the evidence and wait till the game is in someone's hands, and then we'll be able to go from there. I'm excited. I am ready for this game. I am hoping that they don't ruin it. That's my stance. And I hope that we as a community can come together and say that we are going to judge things based on how they are, not based on how we think or fear they might become. Thank you guys so much for watching. And as always, may the lore be with you now and forever.